Greetings, fellow conquerors, and welcome back to Byzantium here in EU4, where we're currently at war with the Mamluks and Karaman in order to try to reclaim some of the old Byzantine lands. Now, first and foremost, the Mamluks have teched up, and we are going to as well, despite the 23% tech penalty that we're taking at the moment, which is rather unfortunate. But we're going to upgrade our cavalry, and of these three, I think the obvious choice is going to be the Southern Cossacks, just for the offensive shock modifier of 4. Just absolutely devastating unit to have. Now, apparently we have actually managed to catch up to this Mamlukian army here, so we're going to see if we can actually defeat them in a you know, pitched battle here. The Mamluks do have higher discipline and thus a higher tactics modifier, however they are taking a minus one for being in the highlands, or being across a river, I should say. Alright, looks like they have retreated, and we've actually gotten a general modifier, Born in the Saddle, which gives us improved flanking range with our cavalry. Quite impressive. Well, that's a good number of men in that battle, but so do the Mamluks. I probably should have looked at the stats instead of just skipping ahead, but, you know, I'm feeling a little impatient right now, so let's just roll. Alright, Austria tells us of the Evangelical Union. Okay, this could be a very dangerous time to be allied to Austria, if only for the sole purpose that, you know, things are a little bit risky just because they're, you know, in charge of the Evangelical Union, which is going to fill up rather quickly with France and Spain, probably on the side of the Protestants, if I had to guess. Although the Castilians are not rivaled with the Austrians, so that may not be the case. I guess we'll see. We could pick up the next diplomatic technology. Not really seeing the purpose, but, you know, is what it is. Now we have a choice here. We could go back to try to break this Mamlukian army, or we could sit here and try to capture their capital. I think besieging their capital is the way to go, if only because it's going to give us more war score with the Mamluks than simply, you know, having this province of Dimashq. And on top of that, we did manage to get a water shortage, so pretty good for us. Let's pick up the military power for this Italian engineer. It's going to give us 40 military power for 90 ducats. A, you know, well worth the investment, I would say. And looking at it now, we may not even have to choose here. Alright, we've won the Siege of Cairo, and the Mamluks actually got a disease outbreak. Rather unfortunate for them. We are taking some attrition here in Seda, but we are going to attempt to engage the Mamluks before they can win their siege. Going to kind of swarm them. And we are fighting more efficient battles. You know, we're still losing a lot of troops fighting them, but this general, I think it was, just got the... No, it was this general, this Nikephoros, our 2-5 general. He just got the Master of Arms trait, which gave us additional infantry combat strength. Or, yeah, combat ability, which is really, really strong. Alright, looks like in a peace deal with the Mamluks, we would be able to get a couple of provinces from them. What we really want to watch out for is the event that a country like, say, Muscovy, for example, decides that, you know, we're being too aggressive, for example. Thankfully, Wallachia and the like don't care too much about these wars down here. It's mostly going to be these Muslim states, which we're not particularly concerned with, just because we're so much stronger than them at this point. Alright, I'm going to actually call back the diplomat from Austria. I am attempting to renew our French alliance. There is a possibility that a diplomatic, like, you know, opportunity comes to us and we're actually able to, you know, get the French to attack the Spanish. It would have to be in an indirect war, and thus a very cheeky one at that. This has been a fairly short war. Let's see, we started this war in 1572. It's been 2 years, and we're already at 80% war score against an enemy who should be, you know, as tough as we are. But, you know, as we're seeing, it's not really turning out to be that case for the Mamluks. Just by virtue of having somewhat superior tactics and having defensive ideas in the early game, which is going to be stronger than, you know, offensive ideas, I think, in the early game. Yeah, the war has been so short that the Mamluks just are not willing to, like, give a good peace deal. Sometimes I look at these flags and I just, you know, forget to actually, like, you know, do anything. We're probably taking a lot of attrition in this province now that I think about it, though. Yeah, only 5 development, 2.6%. Let's grab what we need out of these. That should be good enough. Alright, looks like the magic number is actually 8 to get the +4 bonus. So, I will actually transfer one artillery here. Just to speed up that siege just a little bit. Though I guess the artillery took some attrition coming in, which means he's, going to have a little bit of trouble, apparently. There we go. Alright, let's go try to break this siege, or at least try to scare the Mamluks from pursuing it. Now, one interesting thing about the new fort change that I've found is it actually really discourages, it still favors, like, offensive fighters, just because, like, as soon as you win a siege, the enemy is forced to try to take them back in a situation where the offense can kind of abuse the terrain penalties. Alright, we've won another siege against the Mamluks. As much as I would love to wait for a humiliate here, I think taking something like War Reps might be more feasible. Or even just taking like a flat sum of ducats. Because let's see, we're taking 2 provinces from them that are going to equal a total of about 27 development. That's pretty good. Considering that they're like only a secondary participant, and we get them out of the war, we'll be able to annex Karaman fairly easily here. The other thing we might want to consider is if we take this province here of Erzurum, we can actually get a border with Armenia. And Armenia, let's see, Armenia is actually guaranteed by the Persians, who only have military tech 10, but at the same time, it's probably still would be a very easy war for us. So that's actually something we're actually going to consider here. And Armenia would actually make a great vassal over in this region of the world. So let's see. I think we still want Antioch, of course. And Erzurum is actually going to get us less. You know, I've been thinking about Civ so much lately, because I've been thinking about getting Civ 6. I almost said warmongering penalties. No, it's aggressive expansion, yes. Let's see, if we wait, like, a little bit longer, we can actually get war reps from the Mamluks here. Which would be pretty awesome, I think. And then we can immediately start fabricating a claim on the, on Armenia, vassalize them, use them to kind of feed Georgia to them, I should say, since they've got that disgusting increased coring cost. Georgia unfortunately cored some of the Armenian provinces too, which is just horrible. Looks like these are some Georgian separatists probably that are causing issues as well. Looks like the Mamluks do want out. Well, if you'd give me a better peace deal, I'd be more than happy to accept. Alright, they'd be willing to accept now. Perfect. Let's go ahead and take that. All right, we've lost 9,000 more troops than they did, but that's okay. All right, we'll go ahead and once our diplomat gets back anyway, go ahead and enforce our demands. All right, again, don't think this is going to cause a coalition with anyone of note. So we're going to go ahead and just accept this peace deal, take all of their money, 256 ducats. All right, they actually lost 10,000 more troops than we did, probably from that, Karaman stack wipe. Hey, Antioch reclaimed. Lost to the Turks in 1084, Antioch has been called the cradle of Christianity. While it is no longer the metropolis it once was, it remains an important holy city. Deus Vult. Gained 20 patriarch authority and 50 diplomatic power. And the capital of Antakya renamed to Antioch. Deus Vult. And, as well, without even coring the provinces, we can restore the theme system. So, Constantinople is about to become a gargantuan province of 52 development, if you can believe that. Alright, let's go ahead and restore the theme system. You know, this is really... First. What's even better about the fact that I didn't retake Corfu is the fact that we have the mission to retake Corfu. Just let that sink in. We have recovered from the brink of destruction, and now there are those that are calling for the reestablishment of the old Imperial Administrative Division of the theme. Let us go ahead and restore it. We gain the theme system until the end of time, giving us plus 25% national manpower. Woohoo! That is awesome. Alright, and now we have the old province names here. Opsikion, Thrakizion, Mylasa, Galatia, Attalia, Seleucia, Kilikia, I think would be the Greek. And funnily enough, this is still Antakya. The, Trebizond, still Trebizond, Sebastia, Armenia Khan. Just let it sink in. Got some good province names here. Now, did we change any of the... I think all the Greek names are still the same, but... I think we, we're victorious. We have succeeded. We have triumphed. Now let's go ahead and core some of these provinces. And also start converting some provinces as well. We are just doing great. Alright, and I'm going to make good on what I said, and we're going to start fabricating a claim on the Armenians. We have reached a point where we are just militarily superior to a lot of our enemies. And if we keep expanding eastward, we can just continue to spiral upward, basically. Now, the Timurids are a lot weaker than I thought they were, and so Dolkhadir would actually be a really good... if not a vassal, it would be really easy land to take, I think. But yeah, let's see. I want to get these heavy ships out there. What I also want to do is, with our newfound spoils of war, I want to build another manufactory. Now, is there somewhere that would be best for this? I don't think so. Well, Athens already has a manufactory, this is true. A weapons manufactory here in Sofia seems to give us the best bonus. Just because of the value of bronze. Now, that will go down when iron becomes more prevalent, but for the time being, definitely gives us a nice advantage. Our force limit has gone up to 70 troops. 70 regiments, I should say. We're going to go ahead and clear out these Trebizondians. The Karamanis separatists. It's late. I shouldn't be recording these when it's late, but sometimes you just gotta. You get the hankering to play EU4 when it's late, you just do it. Let's see, Theodoro still hasn't fabricated any claims. I mean, that's okay. Genoa is still interestingly allied with Venice. This could be a very easy way for us to actually get Corfu back. the Venetian fleet, probably a lot weaker than it once was, but that's something we're going to think about before we, you know, in the next episode, I should say. So we'll do that when we get to that, and we're gonna grab Armenia as well, who has almost the exact same color as us. So we'll just have two pinkish blobs instead of one. I think it'll be glorious, but for the time being, that's going to be the end of this episode. We have restored the theme system at last and gained 25% maximum manpower. We currently have 81,000 manpower, if you can believe that. And we're just in a really good position. So anyway, I want to thank you for joining me, my fellow Romans, and I'll see you guys on the next one.